Shannon, do you think it was actually Kawhi's call to fire Doc?
Kawhi could have stopped it. And if you do not give an endorsement, it is an indictment. This is what Kawhi Leonard said after the Game 7 loss. He said, "There comes a that's when it comes to team chemistry, knowing what you should run to get the ball in spots or just if someone is getting doubled or they're packing the paint, get smarter as a team. Basketball IQ has got to get better." Mm. Who's in charge of getting people in the right spot? Who's in charge of if someone's packing the paint, this is what we need to do? He said Doc Rivers did fail to do that. Skip, this is what we know. They can say all they want to that Steve Ballmer went on this. No, he did not. Because Steve Ballmer is in a situation no owner wants to find themselves in. Kawhi Leonard and Paul George can opt out. They don't have a first-round draft pick until 2026. They've mortgaged their future. Mm. Are you telling me that he's going to go against the wishes of Kawhi Leonard, who can opt out with no draft picks? He never wants to be what the Clippers used to be. Skip, Clippers were laughing stock. At least now people take them serious. Kawhi Leonard could have stopped it. If he says, "I want Doc back," Doc Rivers is the head coach of the Los Angeles Clippers. That's fact. Now, he can say he went it alone. Why you even ask him if you're going to go it alone? Mm. If you worth $70 billion and you're going to ask a man that's worth $100 million, for what? Mm. Kawhi Leonard could have saved Doc Rivers' job. He did not. Mm. Even if he doesn't, Skip, in a situation like this, if someone comes to you and you don't give them an endorsement, it's an indictment. Mm. And they will. And the person that's asking you the question will take it as such. Mm. Someone asks you, "Hey, Skip, what you think about that?" "Well, he pretty good." "Oh, well, Skip, Saber." "No, that's not what you want to hear. Man, I like him. He's a hardworking guy. He's honest. I love the passion that which he does such and such." Okay, that's an endorsement. But if they come to you and you don't give them endorsement, that's an indictment. Mm. Kawhi Leonard indicted Doc Rivers, and that's why Doc Rivers does not have that job. Mm. He blamed Doc Rivers. But I want to know, Nick Nurse didn't get an ounce of credit when Kawhi Leonard was on the Toronto Raptors and they won that title. He got no credit. It was all Kawhi Leonard. Mm. Now Kawhi Leonard goes and they gag. He gagged. In four losses, in the second half, he shot 24%. In a game seven, with the money, the cyborg, he feels nothing. He has no emotion. He doesn't know what pain is. 1-for-11 in the second half. 0 points in the fourth quarter. 2 points in the second half. Skip, wear a keychain. You know what? I got something for you, though. I got a little special treat. You better... I got something special for you.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
I got one for you, too. I'm going to wear a goat mask.
No, you're not. No. Ain't got a buffer room for one goat up here. Mm-mm. I'll be it.
I'll wear a crown to commemorate LeBron's fourth ring. How about that?
Nope. We don't want no parts of you. We go at it alone.
Okay. So before any Clippers topic, I have to make a public service announcement. Dear people watching, the Clippers lost to the Nuggets. I was wrong. Kawhi stunk in the second half of Game 7.
Six.
But Kawhi was actually really good in the fourth quarter of Game 6 and in the fourth quarter of Game 5. Look it up.
No, okay. He was okay.
Now back to
not
business.
Good. Okay.
So how do you know, Mr. Sharpe,
yes,
on cross-examination,
yes,
how do you know that Kawhi didn't tell Steve Ballmer when he called Kawhi, "I love Doc. I think we should keep him"? How do you know he didn't say that?
Because he would have kept him. Skip, you have no...
How do you know that?
Skip, let's think of this. Because Kawhi Leonard can opt out after next year. Huh. So can Paul George. So you have the potential of losing two superstars, and you have no capital to get long draft picks until 2026. Mm. So you traded your first-round pick this year to get Marcus Morris. So 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26 are gone. You lost the picks from Miami with the swaps, and they get the swap with you. Sam Presti said, "Okay, you want Paul George? Mm. What you willing to give up for him?" Mm. And Kawhi Leonard said, "If you get Paul George, I will come." Mm. So you had to give up four first-round draft picks.
Yep.
And swaps. Mm-hmm. So there is no way, Steve Ballmer, with the possibility, Skip, if I had him for another 5 years, I could say, "Nah, Kawhi, I'm going to do what I want to do, and you can't go anywhere." Mm. But because he can opt out after next year, you're not running that risk. No way, no how.
So the ESPN story says, nothing the players told Steve Ballmer, according to sources, changed Ballmer's mind about moving on from Doc Rivers. Nothing Kawhi told him. So you're saying it was passive aggressive, where he might have just sat back and said, I don't know.
You're going to do what you're going to do. What you're going to do.
And you think that damned him with faint praise,
yep,
right?
I do. You told Skip Bayless, this is what Skip Bayless, said he started covering the Lakers in 1976, which, if I'm not mistaken, might have been Kareem's first year in L.A. Mm-hmm. And he said this was a superstar. He said, that's what one thing Jerry West and Pat Riley said, say superstars run the NBA.
No, you win with superstars. Yes.
But they run this league here. Mm-hmm. Because this is what we know. Larry Bird wanted a different coach. Casey Jones started coaching. Magic Johnson wanted a different coach. They got a different coach. Even after Paul Westhead won a title.
LeBron James said, enough of David Blatt, and he was history.
Out of there.
Yep. There
okay,
you go.
Okay, then, Skip.
And what did LeBron James do in his first year in Miami? He went upstairs to Riles, as he called him.
Yes.
And he said, when are you going to coach this team? Meaning, get this kid out of here.
Right.
I'm done with this Spo kid.
Right.
He's not ready for this. He's in over his head.
Right.
That's what was reported.
Yes.
So Riles said, I think I'm going to stick with him.
Right.
Right?
Right.
Was that the beginning of the end of the relationship between LeBron James and Pat Riley?
Maybe, but the difference was he had LeBron under contract for three more years.
Okay.
LeBron couldn't go anywhere. Mm. He got an opt-out after next season. Mm.
Steve Ballmer is one of those guys, one of those internet millionaires.
Billionaires,
I should say. He first was a millionaire, but who did it his way. And he wants results, and he wants them now. And when you don't give him results, when he expected championship or at least finals, and you fail miserably, mm-hmm, where you are in charge all the way through the series except at the end.
Right.
Heads are going to roll.
Mm-hmm.
That's just the way he operates. That's how he got to be worth $70 billion. He just paid, I forget what the price tag was, but he bought the Forum.
$400 million.
$400 million, and he's going to invest $1 billion in a new arena there.
Right.
To rival SoFi Stadium,
right.
I'm sure.
Yes.
That will be the new home of the Los Angeles, yeah, Clippers, so they can get out of the basement,
right,
at Staples Center and go out toward LAX, the airport.
Right.
And live out where it all started for Showtime Lakers at the fabulous Forum.
Skip, he can build a $10 billion pack. Mm-hmm. The Clippers are never going to replace the Lakers. The Lakers got too big of a head start. That's like an upstart company trying to replace what we... No, you can't do that, Skip. I want to know the company that's going to outdo Apple. So who's coming up with something that's going to be bigger than Apple? Because Apple got too big of a head start. Google got too big of a head start. You might come up and you might have a nice situation where you have a market cap value of $100 billion. But they got too big of a head start. The Lakers got 50-plus years in front of you, Skip, and you've been terrible for 50 of those years that you've been here with the Lakers.
Never
living in the
say
basement.
Never.
Living in the basement.
Yep.
Mm. That's where you're supposed to
so,
be.
So, Steve Ballmer, listen to Doc Rivers' legitimate excuses to me or reasons why we failed. Number one, no dominant leader emerged other than me. I was always the strongest voice in the room because we know this. Kawhi's no big vocal leader.
No, he's not. He's no vocal leader, Skip. He's not. He leads with his play. Popovich said it. Say, look, Kawhi's a phenomenal talent.
Yep.
He's a great player. He's not a leader. That's Manu. That's Patty Mills. With you go
that
to
was Tim Duncan.
What I'm saying, you know,
yes,
once Timmy left.
Duncan,
yeah, once Timmy left. You go to Toronto. That's Kyle Lowry. Kyle Lowry was the leader of that team.
Okay.
Van Fleet, that's not Kawhi.
Okay.
And so when chaos is erupting, Skip, you need somebody that can't just be with their play. You got to have a calming, a soothing voice of somebody that's in the locker
okay.
room.
So then Doc told Ballmer, we took off right before the pandemic hit. I know the Lakers won one of those games,
yeah,
but the Clippers were starting to click at a high level, mm-hmm, where the chemistry was starting to percolate. They were starting to get to feel for each other,
right,
starting to vibe off each other in ways they hadn't all year.
Right.
And Doc said, rug gets jerked right out from underneath us because we have to take 5 months off when
right.
we needed reps.
Right.
I told you, LeBron needed rest. They needed reps.
Right.
So, again, that's a legitimate excuse, and this might be the most legitimate at all. When they got to bubble time, half the team didn't want to go to the bubble. And when they got to the bubble, half the team didn't want to stay in the bubble, mm-hmm, right?
Yeah.
Are these legit excuses? Yes, yes, yes. But Ballmer wants results. And all he knows is, wait a second, we're up 3-1.
And
every game, we were 8.5-point favorites. The Lakers were only 6-point favorites over Denver each, mm-hmm, of those nights. We were 8.5. So the oddsmakers are saying, you're even better over Denver than the Lakers were.
Right.
That means that you guys should have been, you know, would have been favored over the Lakers if you just gotten to the Lakers. And what happened? You're up 3-1, and you got a 16-point lead in the first closeout and a 19 in the second closeout and a 12 in the third closeout. And you can't close?
Skip, and therein what blows up Doc's argument. Even though they might have been playing well and they had to go on a hiatus.
Yep.
Maybe guys didn't want to go to the bubble. And maybe guys, once they got to the bubble, didn't want to stay. Steve Ballmer is saying, through all of that, you were still up 3-1. I need you to explain to me how you're up 3-1 under all those circumstances.
Right.
Because all those circumstances were still in play when you got the 3-1 lead. So you can't use that as an argument.
Correct.
From losing 3-1 when that was the same situation that got you to 3-1.
Correct. He was asking Doc, what did you do to change the momentum back to our side?
Right.
What did you do to fix the problem? Nothing, because I don't think he made any strategic change.
Well,
here's
the thing. The mistake that the Clippers made is that they were signing players to try to keep them from the Lakers. If you notice, Marcus Morris, they gave up a first-round draft pick because Marcus was going to go to the Lakers. So they gave up a first-round draft pick so they could get him.
They did.
Okay, Reggie Jackson, he wanted to—well, we're going to get Reggie Jackson, and we'll promise you more playing time than what you would get with the Lakers. They signed Joakim Noah. Skip, Joakim Noah hadn't been good since his daddy won the French Open.
I think he could have helped them.
He could have helped them.
I do think Skip,
I like Zubats, but Zubats is not a defensive guy. He can't do Skip. It took Dwight Howard, who was 3-time Defensive Player of the Year, to turn back the hands of time, who looked like the Dwight Howard of old as opposed to an old Dwight Howard.
Okay.
Zubats can't do anything with that.
Okay. So it was championship or bust.
Yes, absolutely.
Rivers.
Absolutely.
And I don't care what you say, what Kawhi said or didn't say, in the end, if you do that, if you fail that miserably, that was an epic fail, you're going to be gone, which is why the next day I said, I don't think Doc's going
to
last.
I believe, Skip, had they gotten to the Western Conference Finals, they lose to the Lakers in 6 or 7, I believe he could have stomached that.
Sure.
But
absolutely.
You up 3-1 against the Nuggets?
Nope.
He couldn't stomach that.
Nope.
But I still believe if those guys says, look, Steve, look, it was the bubble, the COVID-19 hit, things happen, but Doc's a damn good coach. And I believe he's the guy that we should run it back. But if you listen to what guys said when Paul George was talking after Game 7, talking about we ought to run it back, and guys sitting in there folding, got their arms folded up, rolling their eyes like, you need to sit down before we swing on you.
Mm-hmm. That is correct.
Oh, but that's what we see. That's where the leadership come in.
Mm-hmm.
You see, everybody says, oh, leadership. No, there's a premium. There's a price to be paid for that.
Mm.
And that's why my guy, Goat James, and that guy right there can never be.
Mm.
Because he thinks, as long as I go play, and that's fine as long as you're winning. But when you get a situation in crises, it's not about winning, Skip. You need a soothing, you need a calming voice.
Really?
To say, guys, this is what we need to do.
Mm.
This is what's going on. This is how we're going to get out of it.
Mm.
All he wants to do. And then, Maggie, he gave up everything. To get Kawhi Leonard, what you got to do, Skip? You got to tell Uncle Dennis, okay, we're going to give you 20 games off a year if that's what you want.
Mm.
If you don't want to practice, you ain't got to practice. If you want your fiance and your significant other to ride on the team playing with the kids, so be it. He gave up all that.
Mm. So I guess leadership is, after you win the Western Conference Finals, you go sit on the floor by yourself away from the team.
Don't do
right?
that, Skip.
That's
don't do
leadership.
That. See what you try to do.
It's redefined. It's the only way to fly.
Hold on.
I'll go sit over here and I'll bask in my own glory.
No, that ain't what he was doing, Skip.
Yeah.
He wasn't basking because he said the job ain't done. The job isn't done. Everybody, you hear everybody, yes, we're extremely happy because we don't know how often these opportunities will present themselves.
Yeah.
But we're not done.
Mm.
We're not done, Skip Bayless. We got something that's, I just wish they didn't let me get them. They didn't let me get that pregame pep talk.
That is true.
They didn't have me on Zoom. Let me get that pregame pep talk. I am ready.
Yeah.
I am ready, Jenny.
The cakewalk has not finished.
There you go.
They would love you.
Why are you doing that?
Four more games.
Stop. You would be everywhere.
You know what? You ought to be ashamed of yourself. Oh, I can't wait for that parade. We may have to have a parade virtually, but I'm going to be in my car like at the drive-in theater. We're going to drive by. The Lakers going to be standing out downtown. Everybody going, bop, 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 bop.
You're going to be driving LeBron's car?
No, I'm going to be in my own car in the parade.
Really?
Okay. If that happens, I would like to see it to believe it. But can you just cool it for right now because game one starts tonight. Thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show and be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.